Storytime Online. My name is Melanie Johnson, and I am the Executive Director of the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society of the Suncoast. Today, I'm very excited to read to you. How do dinosaurs learn to read? And this book is by Jane Yolen and Mark Teague. The reading is brought to you with permission from Scholastic. And I'm really excited that I get to read this book to you today. It's about dinosaurs. I hope that you love dinosaurs like I do. So, to get started, I'm going to open it up. These are beautiful. Look on the inside. We have beautiful pictures of all kinds of dinosaurs in the very front of the book. Can you see that? So we have, I can't even pronounce them. I'm just saying. I don't know how to say the words. Oh, look at this one. That's a Gastonia. Don't know what that is. Never heard of it. A Kilisakis. Never heard of that. Don't know what that means. And look at this one. This one, look at that one. Looks like he's reading. That must be a Rhetosaurus. That's what you are, a Rhetosaurus. But no, this is a Yankaranubarusaurus. Yeah, that's what that is. Not real sure how to pronounce it. We'll just keep going. So, this right here, look at that big dinosaur. He is so much bigger than his mom. And his mom looks like she has a pot of rice, which I don't know about you, but I love me some rice. That's a good mom right there. How does a dinosaur learn how to read? Well, how do you learn how to read? You're gonna learn how to read, I hope. Does he skim through the pages with powerful speed? Does he use his new book as a shovel or bat? Look at there. That's the librarian pushing the books around. When I was in school, my favorite place was the library. I love to read everything, and I love my librarian. Play fetch with the dog. Throw books at the cat. Does he sound out the words or just take a quick look? Well, he doesn't look like he's looking. He looks like he's napping to me. And right there, look at there. He's got a book about pigs. I mean, really, pigs? What in the world? Does she lose her huge temper, then jump on the book? Well, if she jumps on the book, it's gonna be squished. That's all I'm saying. Does she flip every page, but not really look through it? Does she skip the hard words? Does a dinosaur chew it? Probably. I'm sure he eats all the books. You'd have to put your books up so the dinosaur doesn't eat them. Does he read in the tub? Make the book a big boat? And then throw a tantrum when it doesn't float? That silly dinosaur, doesn't he know that books get wet? You should not read your books in the bathtub. They're gonna get wet and ruined. Does he read on the potty while making a mess? Does he stay till the end of the book? Well, I guess. I don't know about you, but I know lots of folks that read on the potty. makes the time go by a little faster. Does she scratch off the words with the tip of her tail? And she has a long tail. Does he have a big hissy when reading skills fail? Does a dinosaur wail? Do you know what the word hissy means? Well, I'm a Southern girl, so I can tell you about this word. This word means she had a temper tantrum, a fit. It's called a hissy fit. That's what she had. Because she couldn't read. But she's gonna learn how to read so that she doesn't have another hissy fit. No, she's kind to each book, to the cover and pages. She reads very carefully. She never has rages. And quite frankly, when I'm reading, I never have a rage either. I hope that you don't have rages, because reading is fun and it's cool, and it should make you happy. It makes me happy. She reads out each word till she knows they sound right. When she snuggles in bed, Mama turns down the light. And look at her, she's reading in bed. Do you read in bed? I read in bed. I like reading in bed. It helps me fall asleep. It might help you fall asleep too if you try reading in bed. Just don't stay up past your bedtime, because we don't want you to get in trouble. Then he calls to his parents who stand by the door. Please, Mama. Please, Papa. Can I read one more? Well, I feel that, dinosaur. I love to read too. Tomorrow, tomorrow, little dinosaur. So one more day. She has to wait until one more day so she can read some more. Because she has to go to bed so she can get up in the morning and go to school and learn. So at the very end of this book, I don't know if you can see this, but there are all the letters of the alphabet at the very end of the book. So you can read through all the letters so that you can help yourself learn to read. So, some of the words in the book start with the letter D. Do you know which word starts with the letter D? So we have D, 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 D. How's that sound? Dinosaur starts with a D. You know what else starts with a D that's in the book? Dog. There's a dog, and it starts with the letter D. And then cat starts with the letter C. It makes the sound cat. The cat has a lovely chat, which means they talk. B, the letter B. There's a lot of the letter B's in this book because B is the first letter of the word bed. And we know there's lots of beds in the book because the little dinosaurs are reading before bedtime. J for jump. The dinosaur can jump and yell. J is for jump. I jump and I learn to spell. So the little dinosaurs use dog, cat, bed, and jump in one sentence. This dog and cat jump on the bed. This dinosaur reads a book instead. So, can you find the words dog, cat, bed, and jump in the book? And here are a few more dinosaurs, which I've never heard of these. These are brand new dinosaurs. This one is a Amazonosaurus. Do you think it shops at Amazon.com? I don't know. Never know. Maybe this dinosaur has Prime. This one right here, Argatorama. That looks kind of like an alligator. Like an alligator dinosaur. Can you imagine? So if you're a University of Florida fan, you probably like this dinosaur a lot. And that is the end of our book. I hope that you enjoyed reading with me today. And I hope that you learned something. I hope that you now enjoy learning about dinosaurs, because I sure did, and I enjoyed reading to you today. And I hope that you continue to read and find lots of books, because books can open your mind to a world that you've never seen. You get to travel with books and learn cool things and have imagination and go places you've never been when you read and open a book. So I hope that you read. Thank you for letting me read to you.